This happened in late fall, so the days were getting shorter, and they just had a long session when the decision to head to someone else, house came about. My brother handed his car keys to his buddies so they could load up the equipment. Everyone had filed out of the basement, but the tricky part was that they needed to walk all the way to the back of the basement. Up the back stairs, through the kitchen doorway, down the hall, into the living room, and out into the front porch. Everyone was outside, sitting in my brother's truck, waiting for him. My brother was walking up the stairs when he remembered that he left his pancakes in a to-go container sitting on a speaker in the basement. Now it's not clean, with full sight lines. There had been partitions made, and the boiler and main heating unit are right smack in the middle. So after my brother walks back, he is about to retrieve his food container when out of the corner of his eye he sees it. Oh goodness, it is a shadowy figure right at his peripheral vision. This feeling of dread and uneasiness washed over my brother. We had been taught that if you are in the presence of spirit or ghost, and that you felt a bad vibe, to say quick prayer or cuss at it. Oh Lord, I don't know about cussing at it. I might pray and say quick prayer. Yeah, cussing at it, oh, that's not gonna do nothing. Not to me. Oh no. My brother chose the latter. He basically just told it, hey, F you. Oh Lord, I don't have time for this ish. This for the kids. But my brother started to walk to the back of the basement and briskly up the stairs, closing doors and turning off lights as he was walking out. The last light switch is on the opposite side of the door. Luckily, the door was open and the light from the street lamp was flooding the living room with its amber light. My brother said your garage. As he closed the gap between himself and his friend laden truck, he kind of smiled and thought things over his head, mad at himself for spooking out when there was no reason. He climbed into the driver's side of the truck, putting on his seatbelt and getting ready to pull out of the parking spot directly in front of the house. When one of his friends asked, hey, wait, what about your other? this gonna be the last story for today. I'm creeping myself out. For real, this is the first time I read these stories, and that's just creepy to me. Like, not knowing and or seeing something like there, and then somebody else sees something that scares me very much. So that was the first time.
It's 6 o'clock.
Are asking me about a camera. I'ma get one, like, as soon as I get some money. Just being honest. I will soon, maybe, possibly, I don't know. But I need to be able to buy it first, you know. But when I do, y'all will be the first to see it, okay? So